help me.
Turn around and move on, or else.
Suspects reported in your area, potentially armed and hostile.
There's a pace thing.
First on the scene, first to bring you the news.
Negative. No sign of the target yet. No visual of target. Ending pursuit. Over.
So that's exactly what I said. You've just got to call him.
Hello and welcome to today's episode of The Upload. We're talking about the optic and how it's changed our lives. Now, as you remember, Bloom announced a new version of the optic at the recent Tone conference, but we haven't heard too much about that since due to the dramatic events there. Let's cast our minds back and consider... the technology. I mean, the optic.
The friend's official record states he was taken to hospital before he died.
Best place to start investigating, then.
And lets you see your emails, take calls, and browse the internet directly as if the screen was in front of your eyes. Instead of having to carry around a phone, you've just got the small handheld unit. So much lighter and so much more convenient. It's great.
Vicky, you sound like you absolutely love the optic. Do you actually think that it's made our lives any better?
I mean, sure, it's definitely made things a lot easier. It's so simple to call someone now. All you have to do is you want to chat to, and they're there, ready to talk. And browsing the web is so much easier. I remember when you used to... sit down at a computer with an actual keyboard and mouse and type everything out. And my favourite feature is public transport. With the optic, you can just walk straight onto the tube. It even acts as a...
What's his deal, Bags?
It seems there's an arrest warrant out on him and a bounty on his head with the Kellys. And he's been catfished 3 times by his aunt.
Whoa, how's one person rack up that many enemies?
Good question. You could dig around and see what turns up.
Pushing this draconian device.
Got a pint for whoever finds him.
You seem feisty. You'd fit in well with the resistance. You know what I mean?
Oh, you're dead, Sec. Good. I need help with something.
We're ready for anything. What have you got?
My friend's got this rare blood disorder. And with the NHS in the state it's in, he hasn't been able to get proper treatment in months. The only doctor that would help him works for Clan Kelly. Highly expensive and illegal. But I had no other choice.
Go on.
It was a fucking scam. The drugs worked, but my friend got addicted. That's when the doc stopped giving the treatment unless we paid more. Much more. Now we can't afford it.
What a piece of work. We'll get your friend the medicine they need. Don't worry.
Well, this quote-unquote doctor is a real winner. He was struck off the medical register for gross malpractice last year, and now he's a freelance mob surgeon. Nice work if you can get it.
Can you track him down, Bagsy?
I am quite literally always tracking everyone down. Pushing you with coordinates now.
What's your fucking problem? Oi, big man!
Please, I don't want trouble.
You don't, do you? You're shit out of luck. You're on Clan Kelly Dwarf now, all right?
You really see your sign of the case, are criminals operating these areas.
Draconian device on us at all. Sure, everybody flocked to it. There was free Wi-Fi and phone plans. That definitely helped, but it wasn't a case of this is a product that you need in your life.
Why do you hate it so much?
It's just the worst because you had to give up your privacy expectations and accept surveillance. It was almost like the government and Bloom didn't even need to make the optic mandatory. Making it mandatory was only to get the last holdouts across the line. If free data didn't convince you, fines and arrests from the state for not having the optic would pretty much be enough.
I mean, what do you mean by privacy problems? No one really talks about that anymore.
They don't talk about it because we don't have any choice when it comes to the optic. Yes, it's convenient and mandatory, but everybody's forgotten what it really means. Here, you've got a whole company owning basically all the data about your life. Bloom can see everything that you can see. Nothing is private anymore. There are so many times when I don't want anyone to have a clue about where I am, who I'm chatting with, what I'm doing. It's not even dodgy stuff, but I just don't want anybody to blackmail me with this in the future by hacking it. And because of Bloom's contracts with the government, it isn't just Bloom that can see everything I do, it's the government. The UK as a state has become a complete surveillance paradise.
I think you're painting a bit of a bleak picture. It's not all that bad.
No, you're completely wrong on this. I don't want everybody tracking me wherever I'm going around London.
Well, in Auto that drive case, now you might be interested in some rumours I heard. Did you hear that some DedSec hackers have found
Auto
a way to
drive now disabled
its connection with Bloom?
Are they actually making it better or usable or actually friendly for anybody?
Well, word on the street is that they've been able to create an encrypted signal, which means that your world might
have a chance of becoming a bit more private again.
The Clan Kelly doctor you're looking for is close by. Seems he's got a laptop with him too, presumably with a folder somewhere on it labelled Crimes. There's the laptop.
You want to do all this encryption shit instead of me?
Bloody hell, calm down.
Is that...
Laptop scraped. Get to safety while I analyze the data. When experimental drugs are being stored. I'm sure Mary Kelly won't mind if you nick a few.
So with the app, well, let's go old school. Let's call the phone line. Let's call the phone line. Here's the number, listeners, in case you want to drop someone in, as long as it's not me. 0044-203-807-3832. And don't forget to get the permission of the person who pays your bills before you call that number.
Hey, I'd like to report my co-host Andrew, who runs an underground security anti-government comedy show for about...
someone.
And that's that. Painting something.
the point of risking your neck out there if you don't get any credit for it? Pay stubs let the people of London know that DedSec is back, and the increased visibility might even encourage some of them to donate to the cause.
Destination weddings in Italy. There's nothing worse than being asked to spend the equivalent of a motorbike on some sort of boat-based farce in Sorrento, and I always used to really enjoy saying, oh no, I can't afford it. Now they're all getting married in Brighton and I have to go to that alleged beach. It's made of rocks, Andy. If your sandcastle is an actual castle, that's not a beach.
Tell you what I miss. I miss Free Will. That was fun. Remember that? I mean, was it an illusion all the time? Who cares?
I
I'm not saying that excuses anything. It was a chance.
mate.
But basically, you want to stop people coming to you as unpleasant as possible, so...
Well, we absolutely are doing that.
Sweeping the area. Crow, initiate search protocol.
Okay. Right. Yes. Now we can...
No, Andy, I didn't hear that one.
Boom. Set up punchline.
To the rest.
We detected strange drone activity near your location, over. Received. Mobilizing now. Out.
Checking now.
Control, I've lost the target.
Yes,
Control, put out an APW. Target is gone.
Any word on my relief?
Strong in the face of the data assault.
If you have enough personal data on somebody, you're able to predict what it is that they're going to do. You can tell what they might be passionate about, but mostly you can tell what they fear. And if you can tell what someone fears, then you can manipulate them and you can move them in particular directions. Data is collected on
citizens in every possible way.
I'm detecting a vehicle nearby with at least 2 years' worth of treatments inside. That's more than enough to wean our contact's friend off the treatment.
Noted.
There's the vehicle with the drugs in it. Try not to destroy it.
fuck you want?
Don't want any trouble, right?
Oh, no. No trouble.
Ready for action.
The fuck was that?
For Lils and another one.
Clear. Moving on.
Get out here. Now!
Spread out. We'll find it.
initiated. Halt! Failure to fire warns you. Beginning investigation. Surrender yourself.
That's just crass.
Thank you.
This place could use some color. This is just the piece that was missing. The ride. What now?
I found a safe location where a friend can pick it up. Sending you the coordinates now.
So, what are you supposed to be?
Very interested in selling passports and making it easy to provide visas for investment and so on. And historically, throughout the world, they've been working with this big data manipulation company in order to overthrow governments. And then suddenly, all the chickens came home to roost. Nobody could find any receipts for what was paid for. Nobody could figure out how things were done. But everybody had a feeling that something really stunk, and they couldn't figure it out. And yet, it was standing there in their face the whole time. There's a couple of different ways that we got where it is that we are. One, you have a lot of smaller organizations, smaller power groups, companies as well, who are bending things just a little. Oh, we'll compromise a little bit. We'll bend the rules a little bit and try to achieve what it is that we hope to achieve that's good for us. And if you add all of that up, what you end up with is a big wall moving in a big way from a lot of little buttons being pushed. But also there's this other thing that's going on here. It's the gathering of data and the analysis of data has authoritarianism contained within its DNA. It is by its nature a tool for authoritarianism. And it has been used in
It's finished. You'll find all the drugs you need to wean off your friends safely stashed in a truck. We'll drop your pin on its position.
I owe you.
You should totally join up with DedSec. Kick ass for a cause.
Yes, I think we'll make a formidable team.
National crime statistics report a third.
Right on! We need more people looking for respect and up for a fight.
Yes, I'm ready to go fast.